be heard. And that's a good thing. That's part of what this democracy is all about. The second thing is, it's very important to remember that an issue like home plays is very important. And the question we've got is, which party is most likely to actually fund it in ways that help people around the world? But we're not going to be able to do anything unless we get the economy fixed. Unless we can put people back to work. Unless folks feel more confident about the future.
Yes.
It's going to be hard to move forward on all these initiatives.
Yes.
And our hope was, when we came in the midst of crisis, that we could get all parties to come together to focus on these challenges.
Yes.
But you know what happened was the other side, particularly the Republican leaders in Congress, their basic calculation was, look, this economy is so bad, we made such a mess of things, that our best strategy is to stand on the sidelines, obstruct, say no, and since it probably won't be fixed completely in 2 years, we can just point the finger at the Democrats and pretend like they're to blame. Now, that was the strategy. In other words, they were counting on amnesia as a political strategy. That was their strategy. We had a different strategy. Our strategy was, let's fix the problem. And as a consequence of the steps we've taken, an economy that was shrinking is now growing again. We've seen 9 consecutive months of job growth. But here's the thing, folks. We've got to remind ourselves that our job is not yet done. We've got a lot of work to do, and this election is a choice. Because the other side, basically, what they want to do is go back to the exact same policies that got us into this mess in the first place.
Yeah.
And we know, by the way, what those policies are.
Right.
Cut taxes mainly for millionaires and billionaires. Cut regulations that curb special interests. And then cut middle-class families loose to fend for themselves. So, if you're out of a job, tough luck, you're on your own, according to this philosophy. If you don't have health care, too bad, you're on your own. If you're a young person who can't afford college, pull yourself up by your own bootstraps, you're on your own. We know how that philosophy worked. It did not work. We have tried what they are selling right now. We tried it for 8 years. It did not work. We are not going back to that. That is the choice.
Can we have the keys back? No. I said no.
folks losing their homes. Too many folks out of work. So our challenge is how do we keep growing this economy so that once again, ordinary families, middle class families, working families, that they can live out that American dream.
Right.
You see, we've got a different idea than the other side about what the future holds. And it's an idea rooted in our belief about how this country was built. Now, this is a country that has been built from the bottom up, not the top down. And we know government doesn't have all the answers to our problems. We believe government should be lean and efficient. We know that the foundation of a strong economy is a strong free market. We believe in entrepreneurship and individual initiative, but in the words of the first Republican president, Abraham Lincoln, we also believe that government should do for the people what they cannot do better for themselves. We believe in an America that rewards hard work and responsibility for all people. We believe in an America where we look after one another. Research and technology. I want that nation to be the United States of America. Yeah.